Morning YouTube. Trev here, something or nothing. Back out today, more hiking on the Southwest Coast Path. And Sidmouth. Today I'll be walking 10 or 11 miles onto Seaton today. First walk in the new year. Yeah, I've got the Christmas girth to burn off. What I did notice when I first pulled up here this morning in my car is that the bridge onto the coast path has been closed for repairs. So I'm trying to find an alternative route. Apparently there's one down this way, so let's see how this goes and try and work my way up onto those cliffs. So working our way up the diversion, which isn't actually signposted. I've had a lady kindly show me which way to go, but we have gained a bit of height, so a good workout. This is a severe to strenuous section today, which is nice, but it sort of levels out for the end part. Although the lady did say, you're gonna have fun up here today because it's like a quagmire, which is good, because also I haven't bought my hiking poles, so yeah, it could be an adventure. Okay, so this is where the bridge comes in. So we would have come up there. All that's been shut. There's a diversion sign there. Where would I want to go? I'm going to keep going up here. So we're about over a mile in, and we're just about to hit the Southwest Coast Path. It's all good fun, isn't it? It's hard going today. First hill, it's a big hill. There's three sort of main fair sized hills on this walk from when I looked at the gradients. So three elevations. That's the first one. Then one, three. So this is one done. It's amazing how just over Christmas you soon lose that stamina you've gained in the year. I didn't really do any walking for December. Ate loads of crap and it takes its toll. We wasn't up for long before we start going down. It looks like we go a fair way down as well. Gonna have another big up in a minute. But then we was expecting that, weren't we? Strenuous, severe. It's where we were at. But it looks like we have to carve up across that field. So it's a long gradual climb, this one. But then that's two of the big climbs out of three. So keep thinking like that. Counting down. Well, I've made it up to this point. Looks like these are new steps they've built in. Oh. Whew, beautiful. Ugh. It's a quagmire here. Here we go then. Up. Oh, it's muddy and it's steep. Thank you. levelling out a little bit. Walking along this field, you can see it's all been ploughed and it's littered with flintstone. So I suspect that's what's in the ground and just gets churned up. It's a beautiful stone, what cavemen used to use to make fire. So looking at the elevation, we got another big descent right down this time, and then we got another big climb, and then that's the main big climbs out of the way. See the layers in the cliff face over there, all really horizontal, really straight lines. Something you don't often see, it's often like crumpled and arched. I think this is it now, winding into the woods. I think we'll just start descending before we get up the other side over there, the last of the big hills. So this is Western Mouth, right down at sea level. We're about a third of the way there now. So the big climb now. There it is. Looks a beaut. Here we are now, up at the top, Western Cliff. That's it, last of the three big ups. I'll just take a minute to take in the views back that way. It's beautiful, those rocky cliffs just jutting out from all that woodland, all that we've walked back towards Exmouth. We've got a big stretch then from down by Land's End, just beyond there, right the way up to King's Weir in South Devon. Got all that section to walk yet. Looking forward to getting that done this year. There'll be a few camps along there, I should think. Silly little things, but like, there's a trig point over there that I saw on the map. So I was like, oh, I hope I get to see that. It's a lump of concrete, you know? So how my life has changed. I get excited about seeing trig points. Berry Cliff Camp and Lime Burning. Berry Cliff Camp is a prehistoric enclosure on the cliff top. It's thought to date over 2,000 years ago, which would place it within the Iron Age. The area to the east of the camp has a long history of lime burning. The chalk was quarried and broken up before being mixed with coal, a low-grade coal from South Wales. It's a nice woodland area here. Hasn't been too strenuous, touch wood. Nice calm day today, not too cold. Well, we've broken out again by the sea. Just passed the little village of Branscombe. That was quite nice, looking down on that from where I was. Heading now towards Beer, around the corner, and then into Seaton. So probably two thirds of the way, maybe, a bit less. I'm on a mission now. I was aiming today for the 5 o'clock bus, but I think now I might be able to make the 3 o'clock bus, get back even earlier. There's a roast waiting at home. I know I'm going to be burning it off. Well, as I look beside me up here, there's quite a cliff up here, which I can't seem to see on my gradients map. We might go around it somehow. We'll find out in a minute. So I'd imagine we're here. Doesn't seem to be a massive climb, whereas that cliff does look a lot bigger. So yeah, looks like we're gonna go down here and not up there. So that's good. We're keeping at a lower level now, guys. I don't know whether I'd like to stay in these caravans, right beneath them cliffs. They look a bit precarious. The thing is, I'm racing now to get back for free for the bus, but could be shooting myself in the foot here. I'll get there like 10 past three. I've got 2 hours to wait for the next bus. Really interesting geology along here. Look at it. Almost looks like the Badlands or something, doesn't it? Really interesting path along here. All these like little alcovey bits and vines and rugged rocks. A bit like Jungle Run, a game that my kids play. It's been quite an interesting stretch. I've enjoyed it. Oh, pushing myself now. It's good. I need this. Just as long as I don't have cardiac arrest, I'll be right. Well, that was hard. I've just done a mile in half an hour and it's 20 to 2. It's a mile to Beer. I don't even know how far it is to Seaton. We'll have to see, won't we? Final leg now. You can see Seaton is coming to view. But when we reach Beer and find out how far Seaton is, I don't know if I've played this right or not. It looks manageable from here. I got an hour and a quarter to get into Seaton, find the bus stop. So it could happen. All right, we're creeping down into Beer now. So I've reached Beer, it's 2 o'clock. It took me 50 minutes to do 2 miles. Now I've got another 2 miles to do to Seaton and I've got an hour. So I think I'll be all right. Well, this might scupper my plans. The road is shut that way. There's high tide, so I can't get on the coast path. So I've got to divert right in and around this area here, so this could put a little bit of extra time on my journey. So I might not make it by 3 after all. Don't know what that means, but I'm taking it. It's getting me off that long route around the road. Let's try it. I think this is going to cut out a big corner, so we should be joining the road again in a minute. Yeah, here it is. Here we are, Seaton, and we've got half an hour to kill. Ah, fantastic. Well, that was a hard slog in the end. Made it though, in good time, so yeah, it's worth the effort. Burnt off some calories, which I'm going to go home and put on with a roast in a minute, so like this. Made the bus stop. Alright, so that's it. Another episode of Something Nothing done. First walk of 2020. So thanks ever so much for watching. If you haven't already, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment below, and I'll see you soon. Happy New Year. Cheers.